Hey, new Devlog. We've done a lot over the past 2 weeks, and I'm really excited to show you all the new additions. First off, let me go over what I missed in the last video. So something I never touched on was the main way we're utilizing the generation system. Every 30 minutes, the map will regenerate, meaning every deployable, barrel, and player will be randomized again. This helps to add some more challenge to the game. You'll get a warning 5 minutes before it happens, with the warning being the lights kind of flickering. Also, when a blackout occurs, the level of each deployable will go down by one. We also had guns, and as of writing this, we still do, but we've decided to switch them out for a taser, so people can't just keep killing others for no reason. The taser can stun both entities and players for 5 seconds or so, with a 30 second cooldown to make sure people can't spam it. There, that's pretty much everything I missed in the last devlog. Let's get into the new stuff. So let's go over deployables again. We've somewhat kept them the same, but lowered our scope of what we want since the various limits of Rec Room. The current list of deployables that are implemented are beacons, vending machines, crafting tables, barriers, and storage crates. Alright, let's break these down. The beacon will act as a compass to help you get back to a specific spot, like your base. A subtitle will appear when you link yourself to the beacon, which will constantly update with a bar at the bottom of your screen with an indicator that will point to the linked beacon. You cannot level this up. Next up, we have the vending machine. This will dispense almond water and candy bars that will cost scrap. Leveling this up will just make the items cost less. After that, we have a crafting table. Pretty self-explanatory. You can craft things with scrap to help you. Currently, the items you can craft are bullets, bandages, and syringes, although the bullets will change because of the taser. Leveling this up will just make those items cost less scrap. The barrier will be something that you can utilize to block the entities for a bit. The barrier, if left unattended, will break unless repaired by scrap. If you haven't guessed yet, scrap is sort of the universal currency in this game. Alright, the last one is the storage crate, which can hold bullets, almond water, and bandages. This can help to trade items with other players, and overall just have a place to store your items. Leveling this up will make the number of items you can hold higher. Some other news about deployables is that we decided to remove a few, mainly the generator, but we got rid of some other ones as well. I've also added a scoring system, which is how you will gain XP and level up. Right now, your score is based on your time and deaths. I'd like to add more, but I don't know, we'll see. The more time you spend in the room, the more points you lose. The more deaths you have, the more points you lose. You also get a letter rank in case you don't really know what's good, but also just as a nice visual indicator. Something that will go with the scoring system are modifiers for your runs. These modifiers will make the game more challenging, but also yields you a better score. Right now we only have 2 modifiers, Blackout and Double Damage. Blackout will make the map permanently dark, so you won't be able to see too far ahead, and Double Damage is pretty self-explanatory. These modifiers are entirely for you, meaning that if you apply the Blackout modifier and then start your run, only you will have the Blackout effect. Same thing with Double Damage. So, if you don't want modifiers on, but somebody else does, then you don't have to worry about it. You just won't get the points. If you have any ideas for modifiers, please let me know in the comments. We started work on the lobby, which looks pretty nice. I won't reveal why it looks like this, so you'll have to find out yourself in-game. The lobby is where you can meet up with others, set your modifiers, and look at some other info, like your level, XP, and the score of your last run. There's a leaderboard as well, which will hold your current level and the run with the highest score. It should be pretty difficult to get the highest score. Right now it's 33,000, but that includes modifiers, which I'll definitely be adding more of. Something to note with the scoring system is that the points attributed to your time won't go down until it's been 10 minutes. I actually ended up changing the generation system to favor ink, so it's a bit slower right now, but saves more ink in the long term, as well as allows for some more open spaces, which can usually be seen in the back rooms. I've also started work on an AI. So in Rec Room, there's practically no way to make a good AI that is ink and heat efficient, so needless to say, it was pretty difficult to come up with a solution that worked well while being ink and heat efficient. The solution I came up with was to use the player's movement as pathing, since players can't go through walls, the AI won't either. So, if the current target is not in the view of the AI, we will start to add the position of the target to a list every 0.2 seconds. Then, we just have the AI path to those points, and if it can't find the target in 10 seconds, then it'll say it lost the player and go into its wandering state. Okay, so we did some more things, but they aren't the most important things in the world, so I won't be going over them as of now. So, thanks for watching. See ya.